happy Easter. I hope you all are having a great morning. I was so sad to have to cancel the Easter egg hunt this past week, but it had me thinking, man, we could do an Easter egg hunt here at Gateway. And I thought, you know what? I'm gonna need the Gateway Super Kids to help me do an Easter egg hunt. So will you all help me with an Easter egg hunt today? Let's go, come on. I'm gonna start looking for eggs. I know they're around here somewhere, so help me find them. I am on an Easter egg hunt with our Gateway Super Kids.
Oh, hey guys, I didn't even see you there.
Yes, we're trying to find the Easter egg hunts hidden here. Do you know, have you seen any?
Not that I know of. But maybe you should check that way.
Okay, let's go and check out this other way. All right, guys, do you see an Easter egg anywhere around here? Because I've been looking like crazy. Do you see one? You do? Where? I've been looking everywhere. Where is it? Wow, this is a beautiful Easter egg. Thank you for helping me find it. I wonder, should I open it? I think so too. See what's inside. There's a piece of paper. I wonder what it says. Do you want me to read it? Okay. It's from the Bible, from the book of Matthew. All right, everyone listen up. Here we go. It's Matthew 27, verse 35 and 37. It says, after they had nailed him to the cross, the soldiers gambled for his clothes by throwing dice. Then they sat around and kept guard as he hung there. A sign was fastened above Jesus' head announcing the charge against him. It read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." I think that's talking about when Jesus died on the cross. Do you remember why he had to die on the cross? Who knows? Yes, that's correct. He had to die on the cross for our sins. Oh, what a good reminder. We need to thank Jesus for dying on the cross for our sins. Are you ready to go on another hunt? All right, let's go. Hey, Jared.
Hey, Jen. What's up?
I'm doing good. I am on an Easter egg hunt with our Gateway Super Kids.
Ooh.
You want to say hi?
Hey, guys. What's going on?
So, please tell me, have you seen any Easter eggs around this area?
You know, I don't think I have.
We're going to have to look somewhere else. All right.
Thank you. I guess so. Good luck.
Bye.
Bye.
Do you see an Easter egg? I've been looking everywhere out here and I can't find one. Do you know where it is? Where? Oh, you guys are so smart. I need you here with me. This is another beautiful egg. Do you think something's inside of it? Oh, I do too. Should I open it? All right, here we go. It's another piece of paper. Let's see what it says. Guess what? This is another scripture verse. You think it's going to be about Jesus? Me too. All right, this verse is found in Luke 23, verse 47. It says, by the time it was about noon and darkness fell across the whole land until 3 o'clock, the light from the sun was gone. And suddenly the curtain in the sanctuary of the temple was torn down the middle. Then Jesus shouted, Father, I entrust my spirit into your hands. And with those words, he breathed his last. When the Roman officer overseeing the execution saw what had happened, he worshiped God and said, surely this man was innocent. This second Easter egg again is talking about what Jesus did for us on the cross. He died for our many sins. But you know what? We all know there's some good news in this story. I think maybe our next Easter egg may be about that. You want to go look for it? All right, let's go. So I'm going to open this next one. What do you think's in it? I think you're right. I think it's another scripture verse. Let's see. I wonder what this one says. We just left off on Jesus dying on the cross for our sins. This one's from the book of Mark, chapter 15. It says, Joseph bought a long sheet of linen cloth. Then he took Jesus' body down from the cross, wrapped it in a cloth, and laid it in a tomb that had been carved out of the rock. Then he rolled a stone in front of the entrance. Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of Joseph, saw where Jesus' body was laid. That must have been so hard for those women. They, for some reason, they wanted to know where Jesus' body was laid. And he was treated with much reverence. I know some of you know this. I've been reading this with Tyler about the tomb that Jesus was buried in. And they rolled a huge rock in front of him so that nobody could break in and steal his body. But there's such an awesome thing that happened. When we have another Easter egg that we can find, I wonder what's going to be this new Easter egg. Y'all ready to help me find it? All right, let's go. All right, Randy, third time's a charm. The Gateway Super Kids and I are on an Easter egg hunt. Can you say hi to them?
Hey, guys, how are y'all doing?
So please tell us, have you seen any Easter eggs around here?
I've been outside and all around. I haven't seen any eggs.
Oh, man. Okay, well, I guess we'll have to keep looking. Thanks for your help.
Okay, well, good luck with that.
Let's try to find some more Easter eggs. By the way, do y'all know that we are on our new property where our new building's gonna be? That was the old house that just was torn down. This is eventually where you guys are gonna be coming for church. And this is the sign, this is the picture of what our church building's gonna look like. Isn't it pretty? Man, I wish I would know where this Easter egg is. Do y'all see it? It's like just an open field. Whoa! This is a golden egg. Look at how big it is. I've never seen an egg like this. I wonder what's inside. Bet you it's pretty awesome. You think I should open it? All right. Let's see. Wow, y'all ready to listen? This is our most important egg I think we found. It's found, the Bible verse is in Luke 24. It says, on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, the women took the spices they had prepared and went to the tomb. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But then they entered and they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were wondering about this, suddenly two men in the clothes that gleamed like lightning stood beside them. In their fright, the women bowed down with their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He is risen. Remember how he told you while he was still with you in Galilee, the Son of Man must be delivered over to the hands of sinners to be crucified and on the third day be raised again. Then they remembered his words. When they came back from the tomb, they told all these things to the 11 and to all the others. It was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary, mother of James, and the others with them who told this to the apostles. But they did not believe the women because their words seemed like to them like nonsense. Peter, however, got up and ran to the tomb, bending over. He saw the strips of linen lying by themselves, and he went away wondering to himself what had happened. What do you guys think happened? That's right. Jesus rose from the dead. Remember we talked about that big stone? Who rolled it away? It was so heavy. Do you know? It was the angel of the Lord. He rolled that stone away and Jesus came out of the tomb and rose from the dead. And that is why we celebrate Easter today, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, and that he freed us from our sins, that we have the promise of heaven, and we're all going to be together there. So I hope you enjoyed our Easter egg hunt. I had so much fun with you guys. Thank you for your help. I miss you and I love you, and happy Easter. Happy Resurrection Day.
song is the fruits of the Spirit. It's in Galatians chapter 5. And the fruit of the Spirit is not a bunch of fruits, as we're about to see. We're going to start with a coconut. Here we go. All right, here we go. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. If you want to be a coconut, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit. Here we go. The fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Because the fruit of the Spirit's not a cherry. The fruit of the Spirit's not a cherry. If you want to be a cherry, well, hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Let's do an apple. The fruit of the Spirit's not an apple. The fruit of the Spirit's not an apple. We need the whole thing. If you want to be an apple, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You ever bite into a lemon before? The fruit of the Spirit's not a lemon. The fruit of the Spirit's not a lemon. If you want to be a lemon, you might as well hear it. Can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Because the fruit of the Spirit's not a banana. You guys gotta do the banana, come on. The fruit of the Spirit's not a
banana.
If you wanna be a banana, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Let's go to Hawaii, because the fruit of the Spirit's not a pineapple. Hula, hula. The fruit of the Spirit's not a pineapple. Hula, hula. If you want to be a pineapple, you might as well hear it. You can be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love. Joy, sing it, girls. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. This one's one of my favorites. It's a kiwi. The fruit of the Spirit's not a kiwi. The fruit of the Spirit's not a kiwi. If you want to be a kiwi, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Pick up a gigantic watermelon, because the fruit of the Spirit's not a watermelon. The fruit of the Spirit's not a watermelon. If you want to be a watermelon, you might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Because the fruit of the Spirit's not a mango.
Tango!
The fruit of the Spirit's not a mango.
Tango!
If you want to be a mango.
Tango!
You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Super fast, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, self-control.
Darkest night when I can't find my way.
Let's make a J. Ladies, show them how to make a J, an O, and a Y. So you guys know it. We're going to clap and let's have some fun.
Shaken, I will not be moved. All my hope
you were loud. Real loud for your mom and dad.
Here we go. I'm making melodies in my heart.
Thumbs up.
All right, everyone, put your thumbs up. I want to see, hey, Preston, I want to see you do it too, okay? So put your thumbs up just like this, and then you're going to get a sway going. Here we go.
Making melodies in my heart. Making melodies in my heart. Making melodies in my heart. To the king.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Elvis back.
Elvis back.
Y'all got to repeat a little louder.
Making melodies.
Thumbs up.
Elbows back.
Elbows back.
Knees bent.
Knees bent.
I'm making melodies in my heart.
Dance around.
Melodies in my heart. Making melodies in my heart. To the king.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Elbows back.
Elbows back.
Knees bent.
Knees bent.
Knees together.
Knees together.
Head back.
Head back.
I'm making melodies in my heart.
Here we go.
Elbows back.
Elbows back.
Knees bent.
Knees bent.
Knees together.
Knees together.
Head back.
Head back.
Tongue out.
Tongue we out. Can all sing this one. All right, let's get crazy. Jump, 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 jump. good job, guys. Love you, and I will see you soon.